But I do have to get into shape. You know, this past year I had a mild heart attack, and you know you're out of shape when you have a heart attack when you're watching television. Let's see what else is on. I'm in the ambulance with my wife. We're on the way to the hospital. My wife goes, "Bob, don't die." I'm trying not to. I don't even want to hear the word die. I'm afraid it's going to have the same effect as don't come yet. And then we're in the hospital. They said, "We think you're having the heart attack right now." And my wife is crying. And I said, "Honey, if I die tonight, I'm sorry for every bad thing I ever did to you." And she said, "Well, what if you don't die?" I said, "What?" She goes, "Well, then are you still sorry, or are you only sorry if you die?" I'm sorry I brought it up. What, are you gonna fuck with me now? And then they take me downstairs and I have to get an angiogram, and they shave your crotch, or maybe I just fell for it. No, they do. They shave your crotch and they stick a catheter in your thigh and feed it all the way up to your heart, and they squirt dye and take pictures, and you're awake. And I said, "Is it gonna hurt?" He said, "Don't worry, Mr. Schimmel, we're gonna give you a little Novocaine shot between your legs, and all you feel is a little sting like when you're at the dentist." Yeah, what dentist do you go to? Where you're getting shots in your crotch? I would check this guy's credentials if I were you, really. What kind of shit is that? This 2/3, spread your legs. I mean, I had a weird dentist once. I remember I was on nitrous oxide, and the dentist comes in, and he goes, "Okay, Robert, now you're gonna feel a little prick in your mouth." And I said, "Yeah, I'm not that fucked up yet." If you want that shit to happen, you better start turning that gas all the way up. I either wanna love it or not remember it happened. This guy, like I'm gonna blow my dentist on a whim. So I'm blowing him. It's not that bad on the gas. So I'm in the hospital for like 5 days. They give me nitroglycerin pills in case I get chest pains again. And one of my friends goes, "Nitroglycerin pills? Let's throw one and see what happens." Yeah, here's what's gonna happen. I'm gonna need my medication in a real emergency, and I'm gonna be one pill short. Then they put me on this blood pressure medication, and one of the side effects that they forget to tell you is that you can't get an erection no matter what. I mean, I'm trying everything. I mean, I got Penthouse, Playboy, Hustler, dirty movies, picture in a picture on the video, nothing. I mean, I might as well be watching the Home Shopping Network. And my wife is going like, "Is this what it's gonna be like for the rest of our lives?" It is if you keep talking like that. Maybe if you suck it a little. What? These fucking antihistamines, I don't know what I'm saying. So I call my doctor and the nurse answers and she goes, "Dr. Douglas's office." And I said, "Yeah, is the doctor in?" She goes, "Well, he's with a patient, can I help you?" And I said, "No, I wanna talk to him." She goes, "Mr. Schimmel, I'm a registered nurse, you could talk to me." I said, "I can't get it up. Please hold for the doctor." Then he gets on and he goes, "Listen, Robert, this is a normal thing. We're just gonna have to adjust your dose. When can you come in?" I said, "When does the nurse go on vacation? Because I can't face her now that I know she knows I can't get it up. Even if she doesn't say anything, you know she's thinking it when I go in. Hi, is the doctor in? Sure, I'll go get him. How's it hanging, buddy?" And it wasn't only the medication, actually. I was afraid to do it. I mean, after a heart attack, you don't want to overexert yourself, and I was afraid to have sex again. And I went to the doctor, and I told him, and he said, "Robert, it's a natural thing. A lot of couples go through this." And he gives me this brochure from the American Heart Association and says, "Go home and read this with your wife. This has some of the sickest shit I've ever read in my life in here. This is under guidelines for resuming sex after a heart attack. It's best to wait 1 to 3 hours after eating a full meal before having sex. Wasn't it swimming? No, because my mom thinks it's swimming. I remember when I was growing up, I'd eat lunch and go, Ma, I'm going to go for a swim. And she'd say, nope, you got to wait an hour. And I'd go in my room, jack off, and get chest pains. Try to select a familiar, peaceful place where you'll be free from interruptions. So I guess fucking at the mall is out. Some couples, because of fear, cardiac symptoms, or sexual dysfunction, may not be interested in intercourse or other sexual activities, but you can still build a satisfying relationship with expressions of affection, cuddling, and caressing. Yeah, right. Then she fucks the UPS guy when you're at work. How long do you think that shit works? Sorry, I can't get it up anymore, honey, but I colored a picture of a kitty for you. How about this? Masturbation helps some people regain self-confidence. If that was true, I'd be the most confident person you ever saw in your life. Actually, I'd be overconfident. Are you kidding? I masturbate so much, I actually considered having one of my balls removed and having a lotion dispenser put in. You can laugh, it's patent pending. Masturbation will help ease your transition to intercourse. It causes less cardiac response and expends less of the body's metabolic energy. Oral genital sex places no undue stress on the heart. Yeah, especially at my house. You know, I've been married almost 22 years and I've never had that problem at home where I've had to tell my wife, honey, you're blowing me too much. Find something else to do. Are you kidding? When it comes to my wife and blowjobs, my dick's in the witness protection program. Dick, I don't know nobody named Dick. How about this? Caution, anal intercourse may lead to irregular heart rhythms. Yeah, you know, I'm never gonna have to worry about that. Because God gave me a second lease on life, and I'm not gonna press my luck and take it up the ass. You have to have big balls that wanna take it up the ass after a heart attack. I'm afraid to walk to the fucking mailbox. And you know, they say anal intercourse, but they don't say you fucking somebody or you taking it or what? And I don't know if it's appropriate to call the American Heart Association. No, really, go, hi, look, I had a heart attack about 3 months ago. Now, am I not allowed to take it up the ass? Or can I, hello? You know what's great about this book? One person didn't write this. This had to be like 10, 12 people at the American Heart Association in a conference room. And somebody in that meeting had to go, what about anal sex? What about it, Frank? Now we know where you're at. You fucking rump ranger, get out of here, you. When to seek sexual counseling. I don't know, when you're letting your dog blow you, that'd be a good time. No, it's not right to have sex with your pets. Especially like if it's a parrot or a cockatiel, because they can tell on you when your friends come over.
Polly, want a cracker? Help, he fucks me when you're not here.
What?
You heard me, he's fucking me, help. 911, 911.
Look at my ass, you think it's like this from sitting on a perch? People people do shit like that. I read in a paper that a guy in Oregon got arrested for animal necrophilia. That's having sex with dead animals. It's a felony, which is kind of weird to think that they had to write a law to tell us that it was wrong. What if you got arrested for that? What could you possibly tell the judge? Gee, Your Honor, I thought the cat was still alive when I was fucking him. I wouldn't fuck a dead cat. That's against the law. Hey, you think a dead cat scratched me like this? Now, this shows you how stupid the American Heart Association thinks we are. What if you experience heart attack symptoms during sex? I don't know, stop and dial 911? No, you're gonna go, I know I can come before my heart stops. No, I don't know about women, but you know guys are like that. We are like that. We'd be like, yeah, 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 yeah. Oh, oh, oh no, not now. Come on, hurry, 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 hurry. Yeah, 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 yeah. Oh, oh. If you have any of these symptoms during sex, alert your partner and stop your activity immediately. These are angina symptoms that show your heart can't handle the workload. Workload? Yeah, try calling your wife a workload once. Stop immediately if you have a feeling of pressure, pain, or discomfort that starts in your jaw and works its way down your neck into your chest. But what if you're going down on your wife and all of a sudden you go, honey, my jaw's starting to hurt. And she goes, yeah, nice try. I do you first and all of a sudden you're having the heart attack symptoms again. 3 nights in a row with this bullshit. No, first I come, then 911. If you want to keep ticking, you better start licking, motherfucker. What, the pills? You want your pills? The pills are in my pussy. Come and get them. Okay, it doesn't say that in there. They have a glossary of sexual terms in the back in case you don't understand what they're talking about. And this is the American Heart Association's definition of masturbation. The act of exciting the genital organs, usually to orgasm. Usually? What, are you gonna tease yourself? Yeah, 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 yeah. No. Take me home.